For every key point, there is a bench on an adjacent ridge. So it's better to build your ponds out on these benches on adjacent ridges and divert water. Then you don't blow out in a flood. Then you don't have to build giant spillways. Then you have enough material for your dam, and you have less bulldozer time for bigger capacity.
What is a bench?
So the other reason you don't build a pond in a gully is because you want slopes that are less erosive, and you want to be able to drive all the way around the pond to rebuild the pond every 10 to 20 years. That's mucking out the pond, and you do that with an excavator on tracks. You can't do that in a gully pond. So gully ponds tend to have one-to-one sides, one-to-one dam, and that's unstable, and they fail. Wave action, landslides, big events. Mm-hmm. So between not having enough soil to build the dam and having to borrow it from someplace else, having to build a heroic spillway that goes around, that goes either right over the dam, which is idiotic, mm-hmm. you have to cement it and stuff, or that runs around one wing, really difficult. So the spillway's difficult, the slopes are bad. A good stable pond has a 3-to-1 slope on the inside, mm-hmm. 2-to-1 slope on the outside. And a whole bunch of ponds I built, I had to compromise. And I went to 1-to-1 on the outside and 2-to-1 on the inside, which is as steep as I would ever go. And I was like, I can't guarantee this pond. And the ponds that I've worked with the longest, like the Last Resort,
yeah.
we have now rebuilt it for the second time. We built it in 1980. We cleaned it out in the mid-90s. And we just had to clean it out again. And that's because of cattails and biomass and muck. So I like to have ponds, like those saddle ponds,
yeah.
where you can drive all the way around the pond with yeah. an excavator,
yeah.
with the long arm,
yeah.
and you can muck out this pond, whether it has water in it or not.
Yeah.
And then the other thing with ponds is your lock pipe. How do you get the water out of the bottom of the pond for irrigation? And if you've got a really steep-sided pond and a lock pipe in it, you're likely to leak. And oh my God, what are you going to do then?
You have to put in a baffle, but even then you
even leak. Then. So I prefer siphons mm-hmm. to lock pipes, mm-hmm. but I like to have a drain pipe in yeah. so that you can drain the pond.
Cattails are a great thing to have around the edge of the pond, but if you don't have a sharp angle into the water, they will continue their march into the pond until the whole thing is basically a wetland, not a pond. That's the succession that they... They're an awesome organism. The ideal pond, from my perspective, is where on the edge of the pond, when you work in for say the first 2 or 3 meters of the edge, that you have like a 1-to-3, 1-to-2 batter, and then you go in steep to 1-to-1, right? Now the reason for that is so that you can get cattails and phragmites and all the usual suspects growing around the edge. So they buffer the wave action and they also do their nutrient cleaning job, which they're fantastic at doing. But if you then dive in quite steeply, they just can't cope with that as being a place to establish themselves, right?